Concerns around the safety of the AstraZeneca vaccine have been realised here in Australia, with medical experts confirming the death of a Central Coast woman is likely linked to the jab. The government is vowing to press on with the rollout with caution, saying a vaccine is still the go choice for older Australians.
Janine Norris, 48 years old and the latest Australian victim of a global pandemic.
This is a most unusual case as far as its clinical profile, and that's why it certainly hasn't been closed.
Janine was given the AstraZeneca jab on the morning of April 8, just hours before the federal government changed its advice on vaccines that under 50s be given the Pfizer jab. She already had serious health issues and developed rare blood clots. She died this week in John Hunter Hospital. From her family, we cannot believe that this time last week she was with us and now she is gone. We know as much as the public knows, as further medical investigations need to take place. The Therapeutic Goods Administration concluded last night her death is likely a result of the vaccine. While it will be on the agenda at National Cabinet on Monday, the rollout, for now, continues.
We have put the medical advice and safety above all else, and we will continue to do that.
This is the third case of blood clots out of close to 900,000 AstraZeneca shots in Australia, and it does spell a problem for vaccine confidence.
I do think it's important to keep it in that broader perspective because we know that the risk from COVID-19 is much greater.
Janine's isn't the only AstraZeneca case under review. The Therapeutic Goods Administration has confirmed 13 reports of medical professionals giving the shot to teenagers aged between 14 and 17. And while there's been no adverse reactions, the TGA has reminded doctors the jab isn't approved for under 18s.
New South Wales has recorded 7 new cases of COVID in the last 24 hours, all in hotel quarantine. But there's now an investigation at the Edina Apartments in the CBD, with concerns the infection may have spread between 2 families staying in adjacent rooms on the 12th floor. They all arrived from different countries on different days, but now have the same strain of COVID.
Staff who worked on the 12th floor of the hotel while the original case was potentially infectious, are self-isolating until they receive further advice from New South Wales Health.
Also at National Cabinet on Monday, a decision on whether Australians on critical national business will be able to jump the vaccine queue. That would include our Olympic team heading to Tokyo.
We sure want to see our Olympians get to the Olympics, and we certainly want to see that they're safe. I won't preempt the next thing.
The clock is ticking on that decision. The Pfizer shots are taken 12 weeks apart. The Games are less than 100 days away. Lizzie Pearl, 9 News.